Man, I just hosted, or didn't host, Jesus. I warmed up for the VMAs.
Oh, yeah.
And you don't know who the hell anybody is.
Well, I saw on your...
Because I'm 34.
I saw on your Instagram you said you bombed. Were you being cute, or did you bomb?
I haven't bombed like that since the 80s. I mean, it was it was beyond a bomb.
So you went out there. Did they introduce you?
It was the whole thing was fucked. I got a phone call 2 days before, and I had to cancel a bunch of spots. Like, do you want to warm up the VMAs? I was like, oh, my God, good money. Radio City. They'll pick you up in a limo, put a suit on, the whole thing.
Plus, you'll get to see all the celebrities, not realize that you don't know who any of them are anyway.
I have no idea. So they go, all right, the show is at 9. We'll pick you up at 6. You know, they always do that. Mm-hmm. So I put my suit on, which I never do. I go down there. They get a limo. I bring a lady with me. Like, oh, I'm going to impress her.
But I like what you do with your suit. Let the
loosen
top
that
button.
Tie.
Yeah.
Let it undone.
Easier
like...
to throw it over a fucking beam.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Also, look at that. That's a Louis C.K. Rolex, by the way.
Oh,
he
wow.
gave me that.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, for the tour and for... So I had to do it. So you show up, you get there at like 6:30, and all these people start filing in. I'm in this holding pen for all the talent, and I'm with the girl, and she's younger. She's in her 20s, so she's like, "That's the guy from One Direction. That's BB. She's a big star."
Is this your girlfriend?
Yeah,
I see.
She's a big star in England. Da da da. I'm like, I don't know who. I'm in a suit. They're all hot and hip. I felt like a principal.
Right.
You know, I'm running around down
nobody
there.
Nobody else was wearing suits.
Nobody. Right. Nobody. They're all wearing crazy shit, and they've all fucked Kylie Jenner. It's a whole thing.
Yeah. I see.
So I start getting kind of nervous. I start panicking. Like, no one's telling me anything. No one's going, hey, you're on at this time. This is what we need you to do. I'm getting no info. And everybody's running around with a headset and a clipboard. Like,
it's
chicken.
A nightmare.
It's a nightmare. They've been doing it 40 years. Why can't they do it right? I don't get it. It's still a fucking shit show.
That's how I feel when I fuck.
it's a circus down there. So now it's like, I'm supposed to do 10 minutes, and now it's like 8:10, 8:30, and I'm like, the show starts at 9. When are they going to have me on? And now I'm starting to get that thing like, maybe they'll just forget about me.
Yeah, you're hoping, right?
Yeah, I'm hoping, like, I'll get my paycheck, I showed up, they pick me up, they'll just forget, and I'll just go home.
Sure.
And so now it's like 8:58, I'm like, I think I'm out of this.
Did they tell you to be clean or no?
Everything. Clean, don't talk about Trump, don't talk about kids in cages, like, nothing in the news. So... Now it's like 8:58. I'm like, I think I got out of this. And then this fat guy comes in with cargo shorts. He goes, Mark Norman. The whole place turns. I go, hey, that's me. And he goes, get over here. You're on. I go, oh, my God.
Oh,
so
no.
He brings me through the bowels of Radio City. There's a million people everywhere. Sorry. Seaman.
But you go through all these emotions. Like, you went from... I'm relieved. Like, you finally had that moment of, okay, it's not happening.
Exactly.
And then instantly find out, not only is it happening right now.
Yes.
Let's go.
No time to warm up. No time to think. Go.
Yes. And it's open bar down there. So I've been hitting tequilas all night for like 3 hours. So finally he's like, come, he's pulling me through all these like half B celebrities and Bravo stars, you know, and I get out there and you're just out there. Holy shit. You're in Radio City and I'm behind the curtain and this old guy with a headset goes, all right. So, you know, all the names of the artists, you got the rap sheet, and I was like, rap sheet? He goes, they didn't prep you? I was like, no. And he's like, well, what's this? And I'm holding a piece of paper. And he goes, is that the list of the artists? I go, no, these are my jokes. And he goes, jokes? Ugh.
Yeah.
I thought this was a gig. I thought I was going to be doing stand-up. And he was like, stand-up? No, you're the hype man. You got to get out there and talk about all the acts you like and whose song is what.
Oh, so you hear warm-up, and you think warm-up comedy.
Stand-up,
yes,
of course.
They
yes.
say warm-up, and they mean just like hype man warm-up. Who's
totally.
Ready to see Cardi B?
Yeah, hand, like, clap stuff. You know, like, put your hands together. This side. Now this side. All that bullshit. Like,
no,
the hokey pokey.
Like tip, yes, like the t-shirt gun
yes,
type shit.
Right. Okay. Exactly.
You're more the master of ceremonies.
Completely.
Than a comedian. And you
yes.
go, oh, no.
I don't know how to do that. I'm a piece of shit, dry cunt. I got nothing.
Although, that's an easier thing, yelling at people. This side of the room make noise. That side make, who
but
wants to see that? If he
right.
doesn't know the names, that's easier.
He doesn't know the names, though. He's not prepped.
Right, that's what
yeah.
I mean.
And I've never done that before. I find that silly and retarded.
It stinks.
It stinks, and it takes zero talent, and I've worked on my act. I know my act. My act works, but not in this setting, because it's half about Jews and Puerto Ricans and whatever.
Right.
So he goes, you're just doing 10 minutes. I'll come get you at 9. I'm like, come get me. Just light me. He's like, light you? He didn't know anything. We were on two different planets.
Because you're talking stand-up comedy
yes,
and nobody
yeah.
there is interested.
No, he doesn't
right.
care. So he's like, all right, you're on. He just pushes me out there with a cordless mic.
So did you have the names of people?
No, he never gave it to me. So I just, he's just like, go, go. He's like shooing me out. And I just walk out there. It's fucking three tiers, 5,000 people, smoking hot girls. They're all 21, you know, all these hot guys in weird outfits like blazers with no shirt under it and crazy hair.
Probably celebrities and, right in the sure. front row.
All celebrities. So I just go out and go, how you guys doing? I get like a, You know, like, no one cares. They're all selfieing. They're all tweeting and looking at each other. And it's like smoking. It's all the people you got into comedy to please. Like, these are all high school people who made fun of me. And now I'm trying to impress them again. And they hate me again.
Well, plus, it's like, you're doing very well. But you're not like a celebrity.
I'm nobody.
And they're excited to see celebrities on the stage.
Yes, and right. I'm just some douche in a suit.
Right.
I look like the accountant of the VMAs.
Yeah, nobody's wearing suits.
No, nobody's wearing a suit. So I get out there and I'm like, "How you guys doing?" I'm like, "Eh." And I'm like, "All right." So I kind of go into my act, and that is, they're like, "What are you doing?"
what joke did you open with?
I'm embarrassed to
come
say.
Come on, tell me.
Well, I just did the Tonight Show like a week before this, so I was feeling pretty good. Like I know what the kids like, so I do a joke about selfies because they're all selfieing. And even the setup, they didn't even hear. So then the punchline, I was like, here it comes. Nothing.
What's the punchline? What's the joke?
Oh, God. It works.
I know. Right. You're hilarious.
So I talk about how women, they know how to look good. So they take a selfie. They figured out to take the selfie up here. It's because they know where the good sight lines are. That's why women like tall guys. Because it's just some guy looking at you from your best angle 100% of the time. And that's why I don't like short guys. Because you just... A guy looking up at you going, look at the triple chin on this broad. I saw you reaching for it. Oh, that was a fucking nail in my asshole. I
you
saw
stupid
it.
Stupid fucking cunt.
Where did you run your train?
You stupid fucking cunt. Idiot.
Jesus Christ.
But that's what happened out there. That was just a car crash. This was like a fucking train derailing.
What a story, Mark.
So wait, but the hard part is when you... I don't have any relative experience, but I remember one time, I think I was opening for Dice, and the crowd was being really awful, and I remember doing my opening thing, and they didn't hear the setup, but I knew the punchline, and you're like, this is going to bomb, because they didn't hear my setup.
Yeah.
There's no way to fix this.
No, like,
This isn't my fault, but there's nothing else I can do.
What you got to do sometimes is spend a few seconds or a minute getting them focused, and then sneak into the opening joke.
Yes.
Do the stuff that you hate to do. You know, just get them all going, or if you can, get it stinks.
It's like, stinks.
But you probably, when opening with that, you probably thought that's exactly what you were doing, because since they're all taking selfies,
right.
They're all young,
yeah.
Let me start with it. Oh, this guy's talking about selfies. Let me listen to
it. That was my game plan.
Yeah.
And the joke works. It works at clubs. No, I got zero. Like, they didn't hear the setup, like you said. And once they don't hear the setup, you're dead in the water. And then they're just going, this guy sucks. And you're like, no, you missed the setup, you cunts.
This is what the joke got.
So what happened? What was the second thing you did after that? Didn't work. You're like,
so
right.
After that, I'm like, all right, let's go into let's call an audible. Let's just go into crowd work. So I go, who's from New York? Woo! Who's not from New York? Woo! Who's from out of town? I'm doing all. It's babysitting.
It's
that's all it is.
But that is the shit you got to do. With
that's
those
what
kids.
I got to do.
And there's guys who are good at that.
Oh yeah.
And it's an art.
It's an art.
It's really fucking hard to do. Like, I never shit on warm up guys or look down on them. That's a hard fucking job, man.
Yeah. So I am dying. So now I'm just trying to, like, fuck with people in the crowd. And, you know, I'm trying to stay true to myself as a guy walking by with this and that. And I go, oh, I bought Coke from him. And everybody's like, why would you say that? And I'm like, this guy looks like a pedophile. And that guy, like, ugh. And so I'm bombing. And before I know it, J-Lo and A-Rod walk past me, literally, like, 4 feet away from me. And you know when you're bombing, you just reach for anything?
Yep.
So I go, ah, J-Lo! And I just reach out for her, and she goes, ooh! like hides. And
she was on stage?
Yeah, because she had to cross over. There's like three different stages, like a mosh pit, and I'm on one of the stages. So she had to go over my stage to get to her area.
You tried to kidnap J-Lo.
Yeah, and you're not even supposed to look her in the eye, let alone go, J-Lo!
Did someone say that?
What?
Don't look her in the eye?
Oh, yeah, that's part of her rider. Like, that's her thing. You can't look her in the eye. So I'm, like, reaching out for her, and A-Rod's just like, oof, this poor guy. And they both looked amazing, by the way.
But they didn't stop and talk to you?
Oh, God, no. No,
I
was a pariah.
Did they stay up on stage to at least wave to everybody?
No.
They went
right to their thrones, and yeah. I was just like, oh, I could have used you. Jesus. So now I'm back to
nothing.
And
where's the girl, by the way? She's watching this debacle?
No, she's in the back. None of this is televised, thank God.
Did it help you with the audience when you reached out for J-Lo and she didn't even look at you?
No, they were like, oh, he's definitely a creep. Like, we hate you more now. If J-Lo had stopped, might have given me some clout.
Right.
So now I'm bombing, I try another joke. That
What's the other joke?
Ah, shut up. And that goes right to hell. And eventually, I'm just like, I go into fight or flight mode where I go, look, I don't know why I'm here either. What the fuck am I doing? Why'd they hire me? This sucks. I hate this. This is stupid.
You were saying that?
Yeah. I had nothing left because you have to fill air. You got to fill time.
Yeah.
So you have to keep talking. And I look over, and the old guy with the headset's going, get off, get off. And he's waving me in. And I was like, oh, thank God. I was like, thank you, everybody. And they're clapping like, he's leaving.
Oh.
Thank God he's leaving. And I was like, ah, thank God they hated me. And I go over to the guy, and he goes, you did 8.5. I couldn't take it. I had to pull you in. Nobody could take it. They're like watching me in the booth like, who's this guy? What is this? And they pulled
me
off.
They didn't prep you at all.
Yeah. They didn't prep me at all. And I got back to the green room area, and the girlfriend was like, well, what happened? That was like 2 seconds. You're done already? I was like, 2 seconds? I'm covered in sweat. My pants are disheveled. My tie's around my asshole. It was a whole
thing. Who's that? The picture right there.
So I'm bombing, and this is my buddy Scott Rogowski. It was the only guy laughing.
He does the trivia app, right?
He does he's the HQ guy.
Yeah.
He's an old friend of mine, but it was one guy laughing in the crowd, and it was him.
Was he laughing at your jokes or laughing at you?
He was laughing at the bomb, so he took a photo, and it said, hashtag hell gig.
Oh, Mark Jordan bombing at the VMAs. Funny.
Wait, yeah. So when that picture is taken, you're in the middle of your set?
Yeah, that's how bad it was.
Why are those people's backs to you?
Those are the people behind me in the mosh pit area.
They weren't even looking.
No, I was just playing to the crowd looking forward in the balconies.
They didn't even turn around. Rather look at the empty stage.
Oh God, no! They had the best seat in the house.
Right.
They couldn't see me.
Right.
That's a rough gig.
Oh, it was 5,000 people.
Look how happy Seth is, though.
Yeah, he's dying. Scott.
Scott, sorry.
Yeah, he's loving it.
He loves it.
I mean, to be bombing so bad that someone can take a selfie with you while you're bombing.
You literally stopped and looked. You saw your friend there.
I love that you're posing for the photo. Well, I would have sworn that was after the gig and you guys were both.
I wish. That's how bad it was, where I was like, I need to fill 30 seconds with you coming up here. I was like, take a photo of me, Scott. And he was like, all right. And he came up, and I'm like, yeah, this guy, he loves it. I'm bombing. I'm just saying anything. It was just so talking. Bad.
Do you know, wow. I would literally pay however much a ticket costs to watch your 10 minutes and then leave.
Oh, my God.
There was another, you know, Leonard Utz?
Yes.
Yeah, he was in the crowd, and he was filming me. And he was like, damn, this motherfucker dying out there. Like, he's tagging me. It was, like, blurry, and you couldn't hear it, but I have it on my phone.
You don't want to see that footage, do you?
More than I want a different angle of the JFK assassination.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I would love to watch that.
At least
terrible...
somebody killed on that one.
Now, did you stay and watch the VMAs?
No. The girl was like, we got to go out there, Ariana Grande's. And I was like, all right. And I stood in the back, and I sucked down like 4 tequilas and lime. And then we watched like 10 minutes of it and got the hell out of there.
Was she mad to leave or no?
No. She was like, this sucks. We didn't have a seat. They didn't even give me a seat. It was a whole thing.
Well, you didn't exactly earn a seat.
No. Maybe in the electric chair or something. But
I love that old guy felt sympathy for you. He was like, what? There, you got to get off.
I saw the crowd. I love a good what's better than a comedian friend bombing in front of 5,000? This is literally.
That's what it was.
If you killed, it would have been like, who cares? All right, cool. You killed.
Right.
I mean, it's what you do anyway. The fact that you had to bomb and fucking swim and it was only 8.5.
Swim in a suit.
What an awesome gig to bomb at, too. Yeah.
Exactly.
That's perfect.
You're kind of supposed to bomb at that gig.
I'm kind of supposed to bomb, and I got the story. The whole time I'm going, I got a story for my podcast. This will be fun to tell. And I get to say I played Radio City.
Yeah.
Which is, like, you know, always a dream. I've got Carnegie Hall, Radio City, and Madison Square Garden.
Yeah, but when people go like, oh, you played Radio City, how did it go? Terrible.
Terrible.
Yeah. Bombed.
Bombed in front of 5,000.
That's a bad gig, though, man.
Bad gig, but at the paycheck, cleared.
And even Kevin Hart, when he went up, his jokes were doing okay. He wasn't killing when he was presenting the award with Tiffany Haddish. It's a tough gig for anybody. They all know Kevin.
His jokes were good in the room, but he was playing specifically to like a teenage audience. Like his jokes would have done fine on MTV, but when you took it out of that context and like you just watched the video as like, you know, 34-year-old people or older.
You
realize
it didn't work. They don't work as comedy jokes.
There was no host there. No one wants the host to sing. No one wants to be there. Like
is
Kevin
that
Hart
what it
was
is?
There. He got the fuck out right after. Jimmy Fallon got the hell out right after. You just do your 10 minutes and you get out of there.
Is that why they don't have a host for sometimes?
Yeah,
because nobody wants to do it.
It's antiquated. Like Sarah Silverman did it. Aziz did it. Schumer did it. Kevin Hart did it at one point. But it's just a paycheck.
Yeah.
And you get to, you know, be in front of a bunch of kids, so you stay a little more relevant.
Yeah. Right. Right. I'd love to do it. Unless I'm lobbying.
Unless you horribly bomb.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Thank God that wasn't televised.
I'm lobbying to do it.
You want to warm up or host. You want to host the VMAs? You want to host the VMAs. You want to warm up and host the VMAs.
Wow.
I want to warm up 1 year to prove that they will enjoy me, and then I want to host.
Maybe they can get Chip. That would be a funny host.
I would love it. Jim would just go up there and make references to like the like three pop culture things that he knows.
Yeah.
Like he'd make reference to Pusha T, and then he'd go to Sean Paul, and then he'd fall into the Omen 3.
Yeah. Like, it wouldn't go well.
No, it wouldn't.
I have to go to the bathroom badly.
All right. Well, let's take a break.
Yep.
You're going to go, is it a one or a two?
It's a three.
Oh, no.
Combination.
It's got to come in someone's mouth.
All right.
While I'm shitting.
Your podcast is Tuesdays with Stories.
Yep.
MarkNormanComedy.com. Check her out.